Hello and welcome to another video about GammaRay. My name is Giuseppe D'Angelo. I work here at KDAB. In this video, we need to discuss how do we actually launch an application under GammaRay. This is a fundamental step when we use GammaRay, so it's important to understand what are the various options that we have. As soon as we launch GammaRay, we see that we have three different options attached to an application, launch an application, or connect to an application. And in this video, we will discuss what do they mean and which one is the best one. Let's start with the first one, attach. What does attach do? Attach tells GammaRay to inject itself into a running Qt application. I'm going to demonstrate this for you right here on my code. What I have here is a little snippet of QML code that I'm going to run. And then I'm going to run GammaRay and tell it to attach to an already running Qt application. So I'm here, I'm going to use this button right here inside Qt Creator to launch GammaRay. I'm switching to the Attach tab and I'm clicking here on the application that I want to attach to. So as you can see inside this tab, what I see is a list of all the running Qt applications on my system. Some of those are in the dark, are in black, and those are the ones that I can actually attach to. That is, they have been compiled with a compatible Qt version. So all I need to do here is select the right application, I click attach, and now GammaRay is here, open and attached to my running application. The second way in which we can launch an application inside GammaRay is by the launch tab. What does the launch tab do? The launch tab tells GammaRay to start a new application and immediately attach to it from the very beginning. So once more, I'm going to here in the code, launch GammaRay by clicking on this button. And now I'm switching to the launch tab. And in here, I need to specify the executable, the working directory, and if you have any command line arguments to your application. So this is already done for me. And all I need to do is click launch. And now, as you can see, GammaRay has started, and so has my application, which is running right here, injected by GammaRay. And the question you may have at this point is, which one is better, to launch or to attach to an application? The answer is that in the general case, it is better to launch a new application rather to attaching to a running application. There are a couple of reasons why this is the case. The first reason has to do with the fact that some more complex applications do not really like GammaRay to be injected while they're running. They can interfere with whatever they're doing. And as such, it's better to start these applications with GammaRay from the very beginning. That is to use the launch option. Another very good reason is this. GammaRay, as we're going to see in the next few videos, needs to keep track of what's going on inside your application. And if you start GammaRay in the middle of your application, it may not know about what happened in the past. So some things like which objects have been created inside your application may not appear inside GammaRay because GammaRay did not see them being created. The only way you have to solve this problem is to start GammaRay with the application from the very beginning, and that's exactly what the launch tab does. And finally, some words about connect. So what does connect do, the third tab? Connect lets GammaRay attach itself to an application which is running on another machine, as the name says. So it's a bit tricky to understand, but let me explain it using this diagram. GammaRay itself is made up of two different parts. There is the part that you see and interact with, and that's the GammaRay GUI. But there is also another part, which is called the probe. The probe is the part that actually injects itself into your running application or starts a new one, and then connects to the GUI in order to let you debug your application within GammaRay. And these two parts, the GUI and the probe, they can be on different machines, right? Because the protocol spoken by the two is simply TCP. So what I have here now is another instantiation of GammaRay that I'm going to launch as usual. And I've got a small application which is now running on a separate machine. It's the wearable demo. It's the same demo that comes with the Qt. So if you have installed Qt, you have it. And this demo is running on another machine inside this network. So I can select this and click connect. And now I have here GammaRay, which is attached to an application, which is not even local on this computer. It may be running on another machine, an embedded board, a mobile phone, you name it. I'm going to leave a few instructions in the video description to tell you how do you do this. That is, how do you launch an application in just by using the probe, and so then how you can connect the GUI to this running application. In the meanwhile, that's all I have for you today. So thank you very much for listening. Take care. See you next time.